Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure Syncfusion React DateRangePicker using the create react app command. I will also show you how to configure a few of its basic features like setting date range values and formats. Let me show you the application creation process. I use VS Code as the editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. In VS Code, I need to run the command npm install create react app. Since I have already installed this, I will skip this step here. Then I create a new application using the command create react app and provide the app name my react app. I set the script version to template TypeScript. I navigate to the desired location and run the sample using the command npm start. Now I can edit the app.tsx page to show the date range picker here. Next, I remove the default code snippets from the app.tsx file and the styles from the app.css file. Then I install the Daterangepicker package using the command npm install syncfusion ej2 react calendars. After the package is installed, I import the material theme styles to the app.css file to apply styles to the Daterangepicker component. To start using the Daterangepicker component, I imported from the ej2 react calendars package and include the Daterangepicker component tag. Now I run my application. As you can see, the output displays the Daterangepicker and I can select any date range from its pop-up. I can also show a short int in the input element of the Daterangepicker when no value is selected. I set the placeholder property and assign the value enter date range. See here, the specified int is now shown on the input element. Next, I'll show you how to set specific date range values so the date range picker shows that range on the initial load. A date range can be specified using the start date and end date properties. I declare the variable start value of the date type and set any date value. Similarly, I define another variable and set it as the end date value. Next, I assign these values to the corresponding start date and end date properties. As you can see, the specified date range value is shown in the input. Now, let me show you how to restrict the date range selection within a specified range by defining the min and max properties. I declare the variable minDate of the date type and set any date value. Similarly, I define another variable and set it as the maxDate value. Next, I assign these values to the corresponding min and max properties. Checking out the control now, I cannot select the date range values that lie beyond the specified minimum and maximum date range. I can also restrict the user to select the minimum and the maximum number of days in the range by defining the min days and max days properties. I add the min days property and set its value to 3. And then I add max days property and set its value to 5. Checking the control now, I can select a minimum of 3 days and a maximum of 5 days. Let me show you how to apply a custom format to the date range shown on the date range picker. I add the format property and set its value to a custom date format. See in the date range picker how the specified format is applied to the date. Finally, I will show you how to design the month range picker to select a month range using the start and depth properties of the date range picker. I'll add the start property and set its value to year. Then I add the depth property and set its value to year. I comment out the min and max properties to remove the restrictions I had set earlier. Now the date range picker shows the list of months in a year. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to create a React app using the create React app command and how to add a Syncfusion React DateRangePicker component to it. I explained the component's features like setting date range values and formats. I also showed you how to design the DateRangePicker as a month range picker. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you are eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.